It's AumSum time!
How are rainbows formed? Using a bow and arrow. Ta-da! No.
Huh?
We usually see rainbows when it rains with the sun behind us. Sunlight contains 7 different colors. When sunlight hits a raindrop, each color bends differently, bounces off the inner surface, and exits the drop at a different angle. Observe that, here, violet is at the top, with red at the bottom. But in a rainbow, the order is reversed, right? This happens because each color exits the droplet at a different angle.
Huh?
High up in the sky, every color except red exits at an angle above our line of sight. Hence, only red reaches our eyes. Whereas, a few degrees below, every color except violet exits at an angle below our line of sight. Hence, only violet reaches our eyes. Similarly, colors in between red and violet exit in such a way that below red, we see orange, then yellow, green, etc.
Why are rain clouds dark? They're in a bad mood, dude. Clouds have water droplets or ice crystals. They scatter all colors of sunlight equally. Oh, that's why they look white. Now, check this guy. He ain't no normal cloud. He's big and thick. Mr. Rain Cloud. Water droplets in the cloud's upper part scatter most of the sunlight. Lower part doesn't get enough light to scatter to our eyes. Oh, that's why rain clouds look dark when we see from below. Diamonds! Diamonds! Oh, where did they go? But scientists believe that it can actually rain diamonds on Jupiter and Saturn. These planets have methane-rich atmospheres. During storms, lightning turns methane in clouds into soot. As soot begins to fall, it is subjected to intense temperatures and pressures. These conditions squeeze the soot into chunks of graphite. As the pressure increases, graphite is compressed, making it literally rain diamonds.
Topic: rain.
Huh?
Why does rain smell?
Maybe it applies a special perfume.
Nah. Rain is just water, and water doesn't have any smell.
Yeah, dude! So what's that smell?
The distinctive smell which frequently accompanies the first rain after a dry weather is scientifically called petrichor. It basically comes from plants and bacteria called actinomycetes, which live in the soil. Now, during a long dry spell, the plants release oils into the soil to block other seeds from germinating, thus reducing competition for water.
Oh.
Whereas, the actinomycetes produce a chemical called geosmin. Now, when rain hits the ground, it brings up the oils and geosmin, which then mix with air. The combination of this geosmin along with the plant oils form the smell which we receive after the rain.